Blackstone Publishing presents A People's Guide to Publishing. Build a successful, sustainable, meaningful book business from the ground up by Joe Biel. This book is read by David Stifel. All charts, diagrams, and photographs that appear in the print edition of this book can be found in the bonus PDF file that accompanies your audiobook CD or download. This book is dedicated to Ellie Blue for her endless support of my crazy ideas and always making them even better. This book feels like the best distillation to share what I've learned over the past 23 years. Aside from convincing and encouraging me to write this book, Ellie's support and contributions made it much better than it would have been otherwise. Microcosm Publishing. Microcosm Publishing is Portland's most diversified publishing house and distributor, with a focus on the colorful, authentic, and empowering. Our books and zines have put your power in your hands since 1996, equipping readers to make positive changes in your life and in the world around you. Microcosm emphasizes skill building, showing hidden histories, and fostering creativity through challenging conventional publishing wisdom. What was once a distro and record label was started by Joe Biel in his bedroom and has become among the oldest independent publishing houses in Portland, Oregon. In a world that has inched to the right for 80 years, we are carving out a place in the center with DIY skills, food, bicycling, gender, self-care, and social justice. FOREWORD. The underground is bigger than the mainstream. In 1970, there were about 3,000 indie publishers. By 2006, there were 82,000. Today, there are hundreds of thousands of specialized independents, and probably over a million if you include bedroom operations. Even with so many presses, that's still an average sales of $120,000 per publishing house. In 2016, 66% of book sales were from independent publishers. So we are now selling more books than the majors. While the big five, major publishing houses that dominate the industry, have lost 27% of their market share since 2012, small presses continue to grow and find new opportunities at a manageable scale. There has never been a better time to become an independent publisher. Still, there are over 500 new books published every single hour, with millions of new books being released every year, and tens of millions of books already in print. There are more books in print today than at any point in history. At the same time, conventional book outlets, collectively known as the book trade, like Barnes & Noble, Books A Million, Amazon, independent bookstores, and libraries, have neither grown, shrunk, nor added capacity in any significant way for the past 40 years. Instead, they endlessly take little bites out of each other to compete for the same customers and dollars, and the stores make publishers squabble over precious shelf space. Fortunately, there are better options for book sales than competing for bookstore space until you've created some demand for your work. If you're focused and smart about what you publish, you can be quite successful. As an indie publisher, you must be careful and deliberate about your focus, process, and growth. You can ignore Amazon completely or build your brand around their services, though I wouldn't recommend the latter. You can use digital printing to create one copy of each book at a time, or print thousands in a much more economical offset print run. You can compete on a relatively even playing field and make changes quickly and easily, while the dinosaurs are trying to discover how to manage their sprawling size, fight entrenchment, and become relevant again. You can research your problems thoroughly and implement your decisions quickly. Even better, the road to success is also more fun than it's ever been before. One major advantage for small presses is that branding is not an important part of a reader's book shopping. Most readers do not purchase a book because of who published it. They purchase a book because the subject is interesting to them. They are seeking the emotional payoff that the book promises, or the book is helping them to solve a problem in their life. Sometimes they will be familiar with the author, or perhaps have read a review or article about the book. But otherwise, as long as your books look as credible and professional as the ones next to them, they will receive honest consideration from people deciding what to buy. That said, while your press's identity will not be important to most readers, it will be important to people who work in the publishing industry. And the fact that most readers will buy your books without knowing about your press doesn't mean that you shouldn't build an identity around your publishing. I founded Microcosm Publishing 23 years ago as an autistic, 18-year-old, at-risk youth who ran away from my parents. As a teenager, I had very few tools or resources at my disposal. My upbringing had been violent, my education had been absent, and punk rock gave me a set of morals and principles that saved my life. I set about creating books to fill these gaps. And today we've sold millions of these books and have the next 4 years of our publishing schedule booked solid. My meaning and purpose is still to create resources and self-empowerment for others so that they can have the lives that they want and change the world around them. By telling our story and connecting it to our books, we've made our readers feel closer to us and feel strongly about evangelizing our work. Publishing is movement building. A publisher has the vision to see a different world and the determination and grit to make it happen. The best part of publishing is that you get to be who you are, open and honest on the page. Make your publishing an honest, fundamental expression of yourself and your interests. In his book, Growing a Business, Paul Hawken instructs the reader to build a business so uniquely their own that even if everyone else tried to steal their concept, no one else could succeed because they wouldn't execute the strategy the same way as the creator. The number one mistake that I see publishers making is not having a fundamental understanding of who they are and why they exist. Let's drill down and build your movement. Dig deep to find your meaning and purpose. Get a brand new notebook and draft your vision until your mission is crystal clear. Write it in Sharpie on the inside cover.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.